This is Something Dark, a Lauren Lamb mystery, book 4, written by Kate Bold, read by Caroline. Prologue. Princeps, gloriosissim caelestis militiae, the priest began. Sancte Michael Archangele, defende nos in proelio et colluctatione. O glorious Archangel St. Michael, Prince of the Heavenly Host, defend us in battle. The trespasser peered through the gap between the door and the wall. The sliver of the room's interior provided in that narrow view confirmed the trespasser's suspicions. The church had sent an exorcist. Veni in auxilium hominum, quos Deus creavit inexterminabiles, et ad imaginem similitudine suae fecit, come to the aid of men whom God created immortal, made in his own image and likeness. The trespasser moved slightly, and the view of the elderly, white-bearded exorcist was replaced by a view of a young woman crying and writhing on a bed, her wrists and ankles bound. The trespasser noted wryly that this young lady was at least allowed to cover herself before being subjected to torture. Proelia rehodie cum beatorum, angelorum exercitu proelia domini, sicut pugnasti contra ducem superbiae luciferum, et angelos eius apostaticos. Fight this day the battle of the Lord, together with the holy angels, as already thou hast fought the leader of the proud angels, Lucifer, and his apostate host. The trespasser had heard all of this before. The words were well remembered, seared into memory along with the ruined corpse of a loved one, when the exorcism inevitably failed. The trespasser wondered how so many could still be so foolish as to believe in the power of such rituals. Then again, the trespasser had been just as fooled as any. Judgment would be hypocritical. Judgment toward the victims and their loved ones, anyway. To the perpetrators, this judgment was well deserved. Virus nequitiae suae, tamquam flumen immundissimum, draco maleficus, transfundit in homines depravatos mente et corruptos corde. This wicked dragon pours out, as a most impure flood, the venom of his malice on men of depraved mind and corrupt heart. Speaking to ourselves, our we. The trespasser thought fingertips gently circling the point of the knitting needle grasped lightly in the trespasser's left hand. Soon, the depraved mind and corrupt heart would get what was coming to him. The trespasser just needed to wait for the right time to strike. Ubii sed beatissimi Petri et Cathedra Veritatis ad Lucem Gentium, constituta est, ibi thronum posuerunt abominationis et impietatis suae. In the holy place itself, where has been set up the see of the most blessed Peter and the chair of truth for the light of the world, they have raised the throne of their abominable impiety. The trespasser wondered if the exorcist understood the irony of his statement. Was he possessed of enough self-awareness to realize that he was of the apostate host, and that his own impiety was abominable? Or was he of the many who genuinely believed the church was a force for good, and that his calling was a gift from God, and not a deadly superstition? The trespasser himself had been among those who believed. It wasn't until the trespasser's own experience with exorcism that doubts had arisen. Those doubts had eventually matured into a realization of the foolishness, no, the evil of this practice, and of the church that condoned and sponsored it. Anger flooded the trespasser, as the priest sprinkled water on the woman's body. The woman shrieked and writhed, convinced that she was possessed, so convinced that the water sprinkled on her was toxic to the demon that possessed her, that her skin began to steam and blister, as though she was burned by acid. The trespasser used to believe that it was acid in the vials the exorcists carried, until an examination of one of the vials proved that the liquid was, in fact, only water. It seemed incredible that someone could believe something so strongly that it could cause such an intense physiological reaction to an inert substance, but that was the power of belief. It was strong enough that a woman could suffer severe burns because she believes she's been possessed and sprinkled with holy water. It was strong enough that the trespasser could look on while a loved one was murdered and do nothing to stop it. The trespasser's hand tightened around the needle. Breaths came in short, rapid gasps, and the trespasser had to fight to regain control. The trespasser couldn't bring the loved one back, but it was possible to keep others from suffering the same fate. It may be too late for the woman in the room now, but the priest responsible for her suffering would cause suffering to no others after today. It apprehendas draconem, serpentem antiquum, quis diabolus et satanas, ac ligatum mitas in abyssum, ut non seducat amplius gentes. Amen. And beating
down the... We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.